गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, वेलकम टू द डायमंड रूपा इंस्टीट्यूशन नीट एंड टेस्टेड ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडेस टॉपिक इज मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। सो इन दैट मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स, मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस विल बी गोइंग टू आस्क बेस्ड ऑन द एग्जांपल्स ओनली। व्हाट आर द एग्जांपल्स आर देयर मेंशन इन योर एनसीईआरटी बुक्स, बेटर टू प्रैक्टिस दोज आर द एग्जांपल्स एंड सम ऑफ द न्यू वर्ड्स आर दे गिवन इन द मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स, बेटर टू फाइंड आउट द मीनिंग्स ऑफ द new words. That's it. So next question, select the mismatched state. Option one means option A, stem tendril. Stem tendril. So we know that stem tendril to nematophore, leaf tendril and propolis. So in the morphology of flowering plants, we have studied into the different types of modifications: stem modifications, leaf modifications, root modifications. So stem tendril, one of the stem modification. So modification means some of the organs that can modify its structures temporarily or permanently to perform extra function, that's called as a modification. Here the stem can modify its structures temporarily or permanently to perform extra functions, that's called as a stem modification. In these are the stem modification, they're given as a stem tendril. So tendril, a small thread-like or spring-like structures that can develop from the stem, and these are the small thread-like or hair-like structures or spring-like structures. They will become used for the mechanical support. So some of the plants, such as example watermelon, these are the plants that in creeping on the surface of the soil. So if you are going to providing any mechanical support light as a stick, so these plant tendrils will be going to follow. If you can see, this is the tendril. You are going to providing into the any mechanical support. So this is a stick, and this tendril will be going to coil on the surface of this stick. So it will be giving as a climbing, means it will be giving as a mechanical support to the climbing of plant. So tendrils are the small specialized thin hair-like structures or spring-like structures are developed from the stem. So these are the small thin hair-like structures or spring-like structures are then developed from the stem. So that is called as a stem modification, as a stem tendril. Example is given as a watermelon. So we have to identify the mismatched. So stem tendril, proper example is watermelon only. And option B, nematophores. So we have seen the nematophores are the root modification, specialized roots. Which are the roots or plants that they survive in a mangrove area? We are all as a mangrove plants, or we are, which are the plants that they can survive into the marshy areas? In that area, availability of oxygen in a soil is less. So some of the plants like as a rhizophora and avicennia, to get the proper oxygen from the roots, generally roots are they present inside of the soil. So from the root, some of the specialized structures are they can developed from the root, and they can enter above the soil and they can form into a positive to, they can development take place into the positive to the phototrophism, and a sharp needle-like structures are they present many on the surface of the soil. Those are developed from the roots. So these are the specialized structures are helpful for the absorption of oxygen. And these are the specialized structures that are having lenticels. So the specialized structures are developed from the roots. Those are helpful to the absorption of oxygen from the atmosphere, because here the marshy areas, continuity water will be going to present. So in the soil, oxygen availability is less. So to get the proper oxygen, these roots will be going to develop above the soil. from the roof, and they can update the oxygen from the atmosphere. Such type of the roots only we call as respiratory roots, and these structures are we call as pneumatophores. Example for the respiratory roots are the pneumatophores, rhizophora and Avicennia. Option B also correct match only. And option C, leaf tendril. Example they given as a cucumber. Actually, cucumber and watermelon both are belonging to the stem tendril. So here, some of the plants, leaf are tip of the leaf are petiole. Tip of the leaf, this is the tip of the leaf, it can modify it into a tendril like structure, those are called as a leaf tendril. For that leaf tendril, not example as a cucumber. We can see an example for these leaf tendril as a pea plants, clematis, leaf tendrils. So, leaf tendril better example as not a cucumber, so incorrect match it is leaf tendril, cucumber. For the leaf tendril example, it is pea plants and the clematis. And option D, prop roots. So these are the specialized roots are we are seeing in banyan tree. We are also called as these prop roots or mechanical roots. Some of the roots are they can develop other than the radical. So type of the roots are we call as adventitious roots. In the adventitious roots, prop roots and stilt roots, two types of the roots are there. So those are the prop roots we are seeing banyan tree. From the branches, stem branches, specialized hair-like structures are they can develop and they can form towards the soil, and when they can touch it into the soil, they can act as a plant body or they can act as a stem-like structure. They can provide as a mechanical support. So the shape of the roots are we call as a prop root. For the prop roots, better example as a banyan. Out of the given options A, B, and D, stem tendrils, pneumatophores, and prop roots. Examples are perfectly matched but mismatched. It is leaf tendril. Here the leaf tendril they given as a cucumber. Cucumber it's not example for the leaf tendril. It is a stem tendril. So answer it is C. And next one, green leaf modified aerial stem or branch with a single internode or fold. So here the stem modifications. Some of the modifications are they have discussed under the stem. So those are the stem modifications. So they are given as a bulbils, cladodes, phyllotalid, and phyllodes. So here the hint it is a green leaf-like modified aerial stem branch with a single internode. So here two types of the stem modifications they can perform into the photosynthesis. Those are the two types of the stem modifications. So one it is cladode and other one is phyllotalid. Cladode example it is Opuntia. Phyllotalid example it is Opuntia. Cladode example it is Asparagus. So if you see the Opuntia structure, that is for the phyllotalid. So stem it was modified into a flat plate-like structure and with the presence of many number of nodes and many number of internodes from the nodal region, leaves are there modified into a spine. So this is the stem modification that is in Opuntia. This type of the stem modification, stem it is modified into a plate-like or disc-like structure. They can perform the photosynthesis. And here the leaves are modified into spines with the presence of many number of nodes and internodes. So that is Opuntia, the example for the phyllotalid. But the question they are asking now, a green leaf-like modified aerial stem branch. It is a single internode. Here, it is also a leaf-like structure only. Means which all has a plate-like structure. They can perform the photosynthesis. But here, by the presence of single internode. So example for this, a single internode with a leaf-like structure as a asparagus, we call as a cladode. If you can see as a cladode, many number of a leaf-like structures they can develop from the stem and they can form as they can perform the photosynthesis. So here these are the many number of leaf like structures, green leaf like structures with the presence of single internode. So with the single internode, the type of the leaf like structures are we call as a cladode, or they are also called as a cladophyll. So this cladode or cladophyll example, it is asparagus. So a leaf like structure with a single internode, that is we have seen in a cladode only. Example for this cladode as asparagus. And a disc shaped or plate like structure with the presence of many number of nodes and internodes that a stem can perform into the photosynthesis, that is called as a phyllotroid. Example, it is Opuntia. So answer for this second question is cladode, or we are also called as cladophyll. And what is the mean of bulbils and phyllos? Bulbils are the specialized structures that can develop from the plant body. Those are helpful for storage of the food material. So these bulbils are example oxalis and adjuve. So we are seen as the bulbils, oxalis and adjuve, small nodule like structures are there helpful for storage of food materials. And next, phyllodes are the specialized structures we are seen in a pea plant. Here leaf base will be grown to swollen, otherwise they are also called as petiole will be grown to swollen, and it is helpful for storage of the food materials. Because of the storage of the food materials only, it was swollen and can perform the photosynthesis. So such type of structures are we call as a phyllode. So for this phyllode example as a people. And option 3, next question, select the mismatched pair, staminodes united stamen. So in third statement we have to identify staminode means this type of the staminode, a sterile or unfertile stamens are we call as a staminode. So here they given as a united stamen. United stamens are based upon the union of the stamens. Stamens are classified into adalphus, diadalphus, monoadalphus and polyadalphus. But here, union of the stamens, they demand as a staminode. Staminode means staminode stamens are we call as a sterile stamens. But here, that proper match was not mentioned. Staminode stamens means united stamens are they given. So united stamens are different and staminode stamens are different. And option B, epipetalous. Stamens are there united with the petals. The type of the condition we call as a epipetalous condition. And option C, epiphyllous. Stamens attached into the perianth. So you want to know the means of perianth. Perianth means in this type of the plants, calyx and corolla both are united together. We cannot differentiate as a calyx and corolla. Stamens are attached into the perianth. Perianth means both calyx and corolla will be going to united together. We cannot discriminate or we cannot separate. Such type condition we call as a perianth. Stamens are attached into a perianth. We call as a epiphyllous stamens. And polyandrous. Many number of the stamens will be going to present. These stamens are present in three. They are not united together. That is called as a polyandrous. So, incorrect match it is staminode stamens. And next question, select the pair of plants with reference to alternate phyllotaxy. Arrangement of the leaves on a stem is called as a phyllotaxy. Based upon the arrangement of the leaves only, phyllotaxy was classified into three types. Alternate, opposite and Horold phyllotaxy. Alternate phyllotaxy means from the node single leaf can develop that leaves are there present in the form of alternate manner, that's called as alternate flow taxi. So this alternate flow taxi example, it is pea plants and sunflower and the China rose. And it's opposite flow taxi, a pair of leaves are that developed from the single node, and these pair of the leaves are they present opposite to each other. This is the node and these are the pair of leaves that in development take place from the single node. Those are present opposite to each other. This is called as opposite phyllotaxy. So opposite phyllotaxy example, it is guava plants and Horald phyllotaxy. From these Horald phyllotaxy or means of the Horald phyllotaxy, from the nodal region, many number of the leaves are they can develop. Those all of the leaves are there arranged in the form of a Horald on a stem. So this shape of a phyllotaxy called as Horald phyllotaxy. Example is Alstonia. So based on that, question was asking alternate phyllotaxy. It is option A, China rose. It's a alternate phyllotaxy, and Calotropis, it's a opposite phyllotaxy. Alstonia, it's a Horald phyllotaxy. Guava, it is a opposite phyllotaxy. Calotropis, opposite phyllotaxy. Sunflower, alternate phyllotaxy. Mustard, alternate phyllotaxy, and sunflower, alternate phyllotaxy. So answer it is D. Next, estivation of petals in the flower of the cotton or a tree shown in, then given as a diagram of estivation. Estivation means arrangement of the sepals and petals at the bud condition of the flower. It was as a estivation. Here they given as a four type of the floral diagram, that is we are represented as a estivation diagram. A is a vaxillary estivation, B is a valvate estivation, C is imbricate estivation, and D it is a twisted estivation. So they are asking about the cotton. Cotton is a best example for the twisted estivation, means these all are the ends of sepals and petals, they will be going to overlap with the another. So this is the one end, it was overlapped into the another petal. This is the end, it will be overlapped into the another petal. So like that, many number of the sepals or petals, ends will be overlap with the another. So that is called as a twisted estivation. That twisted estivation example, it is cotton and lady finger. So answer is D. Next question, identify the mismatched pair. Option A, garden pea, alternate leaf, simple, rarely, pinnately, compoundly with parallel venation. So garden pea, alternate phyllotaxy, yes, arrangement of the leaves from the node, it's a single, and those leaves are arranged alternately. Simple, it's not a simple compound leaf, and rarely, pinnately, compound leaf with a parallel venation. So they given as a rarely, pinnately, compound leaf with a parallel venation. Here, garden pea plants are that in belonging to the dicot. Dicot plants are that in shows the reticulate venation, but they are mentioned here parallel venation. So the garden pea parallel venation is an incorrect statement. And A, 9+1 arrangement, diadelpha stamen. So if you seen into the A stays as andrecium, 9+1. So stamens are their arrangement take place into a two bundles. 9 stamens will be going to fused to together, and 1 stamen will be going to present freely. 9+1 arrangement. Here andrecium, 9 stamens, andrecium having the 10 stamens, out of the 10 stamens, 9 are fused, 1 it was free. So here such type of stamens are we call as diadelpha stamens only. Example, we are seen as a Fabaceae family members as pea plant. And potato family, Solanaceae, we are also It is a bitarpellary. Two tarpels are present and swing tarpus. These two tarpels are fused together. Swollen placenta. Swollen placenta. Here the placenta will be swollen with many ovules. It's ovary contain as a many number of ovules. So, the type of the characters bitarpellary, swing tarpus, dynecium, swollen placenta with many ovules. Those are belongs into the potato family or solanaceae family. And lily family, next option D. It is also called as onion family. Fruits are capsule, rarely berry. In the lily family, the fruits will be grown to capsule fruits and some are berry fruits. So here the capsule fruits and berry fruits, those are the type of the fruits. So some of the onion family getting shows into the capsule and some of the onion family getting shows the berry fruit. So the question was asked as mismatched. So option B, C and D. B getting given into the diaphragm stamen, 9+1 arrangement. C, potato family, bitarpellary, syncarpus, swollen placenta, potato family. And lily family, fruits are capsules and rarely berry. So B, C, D options are correctly matched with the given statement. And A statement only or A only. Garden tea example, it's not a parallel venation, it's a retroflex venation. So inside statement it is A. And next question, refer to given paragraph. The two main types of roots are X and Y. Yes. X roots are mostly found in plants having leaf with reticulate venation. Here you want to know the reticulate venation is a character of dicot plant. And why? Y roots are mostly found in? Y roots are mostly found in plants having leaf with a parallel venation. So if the parallel venation means it belongs into monopod. So dicot plants are mostly they can show the taproot system and monopod plants are they can show fibrous root system. So here the X and Y plants. X plant it can show the reticulate venation and Y plants it can show the parallel venation. Based upon the venation we can identify the given X and Y as a dicot plant and the Y is a monopod plant respectively. Select the incorrect statement regarding X and Y. X is a dicot, Y is a monopod. Option A, radish, turnip and carrots are modifications of X. If you are taken as a X is a dicot plant. So radish, turnip and carrot, those are the root modifications. Those root modifications are tap root modifications only. Those are helpful for storage of food. So X, for the X, A option is correct only. The question is asking in third statement. So A is a correct option regarding X. And option B, X is found in gram, Y is found barley. X is found in gram. So here the gram plant size Bengalensis. Size Bengalensis. So here these are the gram plants are that belonging to the Fabaceae family. So the Fabaceae family is a dicot. Yes, X is a dicot. And Y is found barley. Barley is a monopod. X is a dicot, Y is a monopod. So option B also correct statement. And option C, X spreads horizontally, hence cannot provide a strong anchorage where Y presents very deep into the soil, hence provide the strong anchorage. See now, X horizontally, hence cannot provide as a strong anchorage. See now, you are considering as a X as a dicot. So dicot stems they can spread horizontally. Example, as for this dicot stems spread horizontally as rhizome. Spreads horizontally and cannot provide Swan Anchorage. Here the Daikatsu answer, they can provide Swan Anchorage. And why penetrate, or why penetrate very deep into soil, hence provide the Swan Anchorage. If you are taken as HC is a dicot, Y is a monocot. Dicot plants are, they can show, they can enter into a deep soil and they can give into the Swan Anchorage. And Y is a monocot, the roots are they present on the surface of the soil only, that is we call as a fibrous. So fibrous root system, this is the stem and many number of the roots will be going to develop. So this is we call as a fibrous root system. So they cannot enter into the deep soil. So in the statement it is C. And option D, one said it is in Y, primary root is short-lived and Y, H has a persistent primary root. So Y it is called as a monocot root and H is a dicot root. So in the Y, fibrous root system, primary roots are short-lived. After the formation of these primary roots, the primary roots will be going to die. Later, many number of the roots will go to development take place on the basal part of the stem. Those fall as a fibrous roots. So what are the roots that they can form from the basal part of the stem? These roots are present on the surface of soil only. So option D is a correct statement only. A, B, D are correct statement. Incorrect statement or mismatched statement, it is C, answer is C. Next question. How many plants in the list given below have marginal placentation? So here, placentation, arrangement of ovules within the ovary. Based upon the arrangement of ovules within the ovary, placentation classified into 5 types. But out of the 5 types, they are asking about the marginal placentation only. So means ovules all are there arranged at the margins of ovary wall. So that is called as a marginal placentation. Third is the marginal placentation examples and what are the families are given in our syllabus. That is Fabaceae, Solanaceae, Liliaceae and Brassicaceae. Out of that, marginal placentation can show into the Fabaceae family members. So what are the examples are they given in these? Out of the examples, mustard belongs into the Brassicaceae family, gram belongs into the Fabaceae family, tulip belongs into the Liliaceae family, asparagus belongs into the Liliaceae family, arhar belongs into the Fabaceae family, sunhem belongs into the Fabaceae family, chili belongs into the Solanaceae family, colchicum belongs to the Liliaceae, onion Liliaceae, mond belongs into the Fabaceae family, pea belongs into the Fabaceae family, tobacco is the Solanaceae family, and the lupin is a Fabaceae family. So out of that, Fabaceae family members are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So answer it is a C, 6. Next question. Which of the following is true? Option A, spike inflorescence having sessile flowers. Spike inflorescence having sessile flowers. Sessile flowers means flowers, they won't have pedicel. Start of the flower we call as a pedicel. If the pedicel is present, we call as pedicellate flower. If the pedicel is absent, we call as a sessile flower. Spike inflorescence having sessile flowers. And option B, umbel is a racemose flower inflorescence where all stalked flowers are aggregated. A flat receptacle. See now, umbel is a racemose inflorescence. All of the flowers are there aggregated in the form of centripetally. Centripetally arrangement of the flowers. So older flowers are there present at the periphery and the new flowers are there present at the center. And option C, racemose is a racemose inflorescence having main axis shorted flowers born apropetally. So racemes, we call as a racemose inflorescence having main axis. It's not a shortened, it's present in the form of a long length. Arrangement of the flowers all are in apropetal manner. And option D, Sphagis is a racemose inflorescence having pendulous spike with axis much flattened. So, you know, Sphagis inflorescence is entirely covered with a sheath-like structure. The sheath-like structure we call as spathe. So it is seen in coconut. So it's a racemose inflorescence with a pendulous spike. It's having as a pendulous spike, means what are the flowers are they present in a Sphagis inflorescence? Those are the flowers are sessile flower. Main axis is much flattened. Here the main axis is not flattened condition. So what are the options are they given? Out of the given options, they have to identify as a correct statement. The correct statement in the D option belongs into the Sphagis inflorescence. They're given as a much flattened main axis. It does not contain as a much flattened condition. And option C, they're given as a racemose, means racem is a racemose inflorescence. Main axis is a shortened. It's not a shortened. It's having a long length. And umbel is a racemose inflorescence where all start the flowers. Umbel is a racemose inflorescence. Arrangement of the flowers from the receptacle. It is present in the form of a centripetal order. And option A, spike inflorescence having sessile flowers. Yes, spike inflorescence having as a sessile flowers. Means flowers are, they won't have any pedicel. And 10th question. Which of the following is correctly matched? Monstera, they're given as a taproot system. It's not a taproot system. It then shows into the fibrous root system. Many number of root caps are we are seeing in Monstera. And Dahlia, it then shows into the fasciculated root. So fasciculated roots are many number of the tuber-like structures are that can develop in the form of a bunch. So that is all as a fasciculated root. So for the fasciculated roots, example as a Dahlia. And option C, Ajanda recta, name, scientific name, it's a given as adventitious root. It's not adventitious root, it's a taproot. And basil, they're given as a prop root. So the prop root, better example, it's a banyan tree, not as a basil plant. So answer it is, out of the given options, correct match is Dahlia. It's a shows facilitated root modification. And last one, there is pineapple. Ananas fruit develops from. So pineapple inflorescence it is sorosis, a specialized inflorescence we can see. And these are the specialized inflorescence. Entire inflorescence then act as a flower. Arrangement of the flowers on a floral axis it's called as inflorescence. And these are the inflorescence, racemose inflorescence, cymose inflorescence, and mix the special type of inflorescence we are discussing. So pineapple belongs into the mixed type of the or special type of the inflorescence in that and shows into these pineapple then shows the sorosis type of the fruit. So at the time of the sorosis fruit formation or pineapple fruit formation, at the time what are the flowers are they present on a main axis? So all of the flowers means entire inflorescence can act as a root. Means all of the flowers are present on the main axis. This main axis with the flowers all are then act as a root. So options are option A, multilocular monotarpellary flowers. A multilocular monotarpellary, single tarpel with presence of many number of locules. And option B, unilocular polytarpellary. Many number of tarpels are there present. Those tarpels are contain united and they are called as a unilocular. And option C, a multi-pistillate syntapus flower. Here, flower contain as a many number of pistils. So those all of the pistils are, they are united. That is called as a syntapus. So now, here, multi-pistillate syntapus flowers. So here, single flower is not involved in the formation of the pineapple fruit. And option D, a cluster of compactly bound flowers on a axis. So now here the many number of the flowers are arranged on a main axis. These all of the flowers which the main axis means inflorescence is used are involved into the formation of fruit of pineapple. So that pineapple fruit is a So answer it is D.